Well, hello everyone. Greetings from North Idaho. You know, I have no idea if my internet is going to be sufficient to do this video tonight, but we'll find out. All right? How about that? We'll find out if it will work. Man, I had an incredible Sabbath, and I want to share some of it with you this evening, and maybe read a couple things to you that might encourage you and give you peace. That's what we need, right? We need the peace of Jesus in our hearts and our souls. And I got a great big chunk of that today. Let's see if I could change the picture here. So far, not so good. I think it's because the internet signal here is probably insufficient. We'll see what we can do here. We'll see if I can fix it. Let's see. Okay. So today, I went for a hike in two different locations. The first one's here in a place called Rathdrum Mountain. And I just want to share some of the things that I saw today as I hiked up this mountain. The great plain that you could see off in the distance behind the trees is the city of Rathdrum down below, and probably if the eye could see far enough, you could see a bit of Quarter Lane, Idaho from the top of this mountain. Here's one of the trailheads, just a gigantic alpine forest with tremendous beauty. You can see below a bit of a road. That was the road that I used to hike up to this particular point. And you can see that between two mountain ranges, you can see the opposite mountain range off in the distance. So between those two mountain ranges is just a gigantic plain where the city of Rathdrum, Hyden, Coeur d'Alene, Post Falls, they all just kind of lie in this great expanse between these two mountain ranges. And so I was in the town of Rathdrum on Rathdrum Mountain today. And these are just some of the spectacular views that I was provided as I hiked up the mountain and through the woods. Some gigantic, I have some really good videos that I posted on Facebook today. I was able to get up close to some gigantic cedars that were just majestic and beautiful. But the thing that I desired most today was just to remember, just to contemplate, that all these magnificent things that we witness, that we are blessed to be able to spend time in, all of these things were created for him and by him. By Jesus Christ. He created them for his good pleasure. Because it is his pleasure that we would be blessed, that we would be comforted, that we were to be provided for, that we would have just this landscape of tremendous beauty to behold and to contemplate the power, the wonder, the might, the grace and mercy of our loving Savior Jesus Christ and his Father, our God. And today I just got to spend a little bit of time doing that very thing, just contemplating the power and majesty of our God. So this is my first Sabbath in the state of Idaho, and it was my desire just to update you on how God is blessing my life. I do covet your prayers as I'm here trying to establish this new job that I've been provided, get my license and everything straightened out, find a home for my family. I have, by the way, this week, put an offer on a home that my family seems to be very happy about. They have until tomorrow to answer, so we'll find out very soon if we are going to be buying a house. So there's a lot of things going on, and we covet your prayers. It's just beautiful here, and I have already encountered opportunities where I could witness, where I could share, where I could give testimony to the goodness of the Lord. And, you know, that was one of my big questions. Lord, if this is where you want me to be, why is it you want me to be there? If you know me, if you're aware of the kind of man that God has transformed me and created in me, if you know that man, you know that I'm going to find some way, one way or the other, to minister of his goodness and his grace, to speak of him, to testify on his behalf in hopes of bringing some glory to his name and maybe even being of some help or some encouragement to someone else, leading them to the cross of Calvary. It's just a desire that has been implanted in my heart, and I can't function without the pursuit of that goal of somehow bringing glory to the man who has saved me, to the man Christ Jesus. So I'm walking today, I'm considering these things, and there's some things that came to mind. Some scripture I'm sure you're familiar with. For example, in Romans chapter 1, verses 19 and 20, it says this: "For what can be known about God is plain to them, because God has shown it to them. For his invisible attributes, namely his eternal power and divine nature, have been clearly perceived ever since the creation of the world in the things that have been made, so they are without excuse." I am certainly without excuse after a day like today, after this incredible Sabbath that I've experienced in this beautiful place. There's no way that I could dismiss out of hand that there must be a creator, that there must be a being of such remarkable power and intelligence and foresight and goodness to create the things that I've witnessed today. It can't be dismissed. In the book of Genesis, first chapter, in verse 10, it says, God called the dry land earth, and the waters he gathered together, and he called those seas. And God saw that it was good. Today, I also saw that it was good. Man, is it good. Praise the Lord for North Idaho. Just tremendously beautiful. There's one other interesting thing I'd like to share. This comes from manuscripts. I think it's Manuscripts 29. This was written in 1885. I think some of you might appreciate this. The author wrote, I have thought that there could be nothing to exceed the grandeur of the Colorado Mountains. But we see that which is fully as grand, and which awakens the soul reverence for God. We seem to behold his majesty and his power in his marvelous works. The varied scenery in the towering mountains and rocky heights, the deep mountain gorges with their rapid, noisy streams of water coming from the mountains above, the many cataracts that come tumbling down from the tops of the mountains, the waters breaking as they strike the rock and scattering into spray like a veil, render this scenery altogether one of surpassing beauty and grandeur. Mountains contain God's blessing. I have seen men and women look upon the majesty of mountains as though they were really a deformity of nature. They would sigh and say, how needless. Let me have the level plain, the broad prairies, and I should be happy. The mountains contain treasures of blessing which the Creator bestows upon the inhabitants of the earth. It is the diversity in the surface of the earth, in mountains, plains, and valleys, which reveal the wisdom and the power of the great master worker. And those who would banish from the earth the rocks and mountains, the wild gorges, and the noisy rushing streams, the precipice as unsightly deformities in nature, and would have a smooth level, their senses are too limited to comprehend the majesty of God. Their minds are bound about with narrow ideals. God, the great architect, has built these lofty mountains, and their influence upon climate is a blessing to our world. They draw from the clouds in rich moisture. Mountain chains are God's great reservoirs to supply the ocean with its water. These are the sources of the springs, rills, and brooks, as well as the rivers. They receive, in the form of rain and snow, the vapors with which the atmosphere is charged, and communicate them to the parched plains below. We should look upon the irregular mountains of the earth as God's fountain of blessing, from which flow forth the waters to supply all the living creation. Every time I look upon the mountains, I feel gratitude to God. My heart is lifted up in praise to him who knows the wants and needs of man. In the earth had been a uniform level, there would be no stagnant marshes. Beautiful. This is what I have seen today. This is what I wanted to share with you. The goodness of God. God bless you. And have a wonderful Sabbath evening as we start this new week. May God bless you through this new week. In Jesus' name, amen.